The story of civilization itself begins perhaps in the most unlikely of places, an area we call Mesopotamia, or the land between the rivers. And these rivers, of course, are going to be the Tigris and the Euphrates, in what we would call modern-day Iraq, for the most part. At first glance, it's surprising it shows up here. It's probably the least likely place where civilization would appear outside of Antarctica. Average summer temperatures can be as high as 104, that's average, and it can spike up to 120 degrees. There's little rainfall, there's no natural barriers to protect against windstorms and floods, and intruders can sweep through these areas really quickly because it's flat. It's essentially a large plain between two rivers, surrounded by desert, little frontier, and therefore has little to offer to create a nation. Before the advent of the empires in this Mesopotamia area, the people that lived there are kind of like the Kurds of today. They're living in, say, Iraq, Syria, Turkey, and Iran. They're stateless. Resources in this area are few. There's no stone. There's no metal. There's no trees out there to make lumber, to make large buildings. There was, however, one really good thing, and it's going to be soil. You see, over the centuries and the millennia, the Tigris and the Euphrates would basically start depositing all of this fertile soil throughout this valley. And that basically is going to allow you to have at least a society and up to a civilization be supported through this water in terms of food production. And if you notice, the earliest civilizations, the vast majority of them, are founded around water. Think about it. You know, Indian civilization has the Indus. The Egyptians have the Nile. The Romans have the Tiber, and we have, not to mention, the Yangtze River in China. So once the Sumerians developed an irrigation system, water from the rivers are going to help make agriculture possible. Now, during the Neolithic era, farmers living in very small communities are going to be living along the Tigris River. Over time, these people and others are going to start moving down particularly the floodplains of the neighboring Euphrates, and using this irrigation to grow enough crops to be able to create villages. And by around 4000 BC, these peoples had developed the first cosmopolitan civilization. They expanded their agriculture, which was going across the plain, to the Tigris River, which gave them more land to cultivate, but also gives greater challenges. For example, the Tigris is a fast-moving and deep river. Basically, so that means that its rivers are very hard to tap for irrigation. Put on top of that, it actually floods at the wrong time of the year if you're a farmer. If you're a farmer, you don't want crops to be inundated with water in March and April, because that's the time that they are ripening. Well, unfortunately, the Tigris floods during this time period, in April most likely, right when the grains are ripening. More sophisticated engineers and greater numbers of workers are needed to trap that water into reservoirs and distribute it more evenly, particularly in time periods of drought and of dryness. But nonetheless, once the Sumerians are able to harness these waters, they could support a population of unprecedented density.